Welcome to Broadcast. First up today, we have a feature story on student news regarding the return to full in-person learning.
Now that we're back in school, we get students' opinions on going back to school full in person.
What is your favorite type of learning at school, like hybrid, online, or full in person?
I prefer hybrid, just because it gives me a little more time to do my stuff, and it's a lot less stressful than fully in class.
What were you doing more? Like, were you working more, just hanging out?
I'd say I was probably working less than what I would be working on in school. I'd more just hang out at home, really.
So, like, you wouldn't go to, like, your job then or anything?
Well, yeah, I'd go to my job. You know, that's really the only thing that I'd be doing if I left the house during hybrid, which is kind of unhealthy, but...
Do you think that school will give students the option to pick which type of learning they will want in the future?
I think so, yeah, because at least for the next few years, people are still going to be concerned about getting it and spreading it, and I think that they want that peace of mind to know, like, they don't have to come to a school filled with, you know, hundreds of kids.
It's great being back to school. I like having the structured back, seeing my friends, hanging out with them.
I don't particularly like full-time school, especially since we've had a full year off and our lives have changed to fit that. And I don't like waking up. I'd rather go to work.
Coming back to school is a big change. I think I just got used to staying up later on like Thursday and Friday. I don't have a job, so it doesn't interfere, and I think this is going to last a week at best. The way we're crammed together, we're going to have more COVID cases.
What is your favorite type of learning at school, like hybrid, online, or full in person?
I like the hybrid learning because you get like a lot of time to like do homework and things like that. And if you wanted to work, you could work. But also, it's good to be back full in person because you get to see everybody, because you couldn't really do that in hybrid learning.
Like on your hybrid days, what were you doing more often? Like, were you working, just hanging out, doing dumb stuff?
I guess more just hanging out. I was working more in the summer, and then when we kind of got back, it was all distance, so I was still working. But then once we kind of got to the hybrid full in person, I wasn't working a job, but just still focusing on school and just hanging out more.
Do you think that schools will give students the option to pick which type of learning they will want in the future?
I think it depends on like what happens with the whole pandemic. I mean, if we are still in masks and we still have to social distance for a long time, I wouldn't be surprised if they like gave you an option if you wanted a hybrid or distance or whatever you wanted to do, or be back full in person. But, and also that's kind of like what colleges are doing, is like hybrid also. Like they get to go to class sometimes and they're not in class sometimes, so I think they might be able to give the option, but I'm not too sure what they will do.
Like even after pandemic also, or like during the pandemic?
I think both. I mean, after like hybrid, I feel like hybrid's going pretty well for most people. I mean, there's some people who might not be doing the best with it, so they might choose to go like full-time back in school, but I bet they could give the option after the pandemic.
All right. Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
Here are our upcoming birthdays for the week of March 17th to 23rd. Ryan Hunter, James Saget, Evie Wagner, Grace Hollering, Grain Johnson, Isabel Pilova, Jonathan Grahams, Michael McLoon, Shaylin Tepley, Sawyer Kuehl, Grace Fisher, Samantha Nielsen, Devin Van Isle, Braden Everson, Libby Kruger, Sydney Stinger, Kale Mallory, Owen Precker, Maximum Eichens, McKenna Johnson, Carly Wiener, Carter Gregg, Hannah Kraft, Dean Gordon, Alec Dolman, Abigail Pint, and Jessica Dropic. Happy birthday to all of you from New Prague High School.
Happy birthday. This week's Great Great segment takes us to Hawaii.
Thank you. A few minutes later. A few moments later.
Activities for the week start with boys basketball varsity section quarters. On March 18th, gymnastics is at Bloomington Jefferson for the Section 2AA championship, and both boys and girls hockey have varsity section semifinals. On Friday, March 19th, girls basketball is heading to the varsity section semifinals. March 20th has the speech team at Northfield. Girls hockey varsity section finals, boys basketball varsity section semifinals, and boys hockey varsity section semifinals. On Monday, boys basketball grades 7 and 8 are at Faribault. Many events are live streamed. See the activities office for more details. Good luck to all the teams this week.
And now for our next story, which will follow with a commercial break.
According to AAA, gas prices are rising faster than we've ever seen before. Some of the reasons why gas prices are becoming so high is because crude oil prices are surging, harsh winter has been tough on refineries, the pandemic knocked out refineries, vaccinations are expected to boost travel, and stimulus checks will drive up spending and prices. They say that drivers could find themselves spending up to $3 a gallon on average by Memorial Day. Most teenagers don't have a ton of money to spend, and with the gas rising, how will they afford getting around now? We went around New Prague to capture the different gas prices, then we asked some students, along with teachers at New Prague High School, their thoughts on the gas prices rising, and here's what they had to say.
I don't really feel a major impact by them since I never drive many places, so I don't go through a whole lot of gas, so it doesn't really affect me.
Gas has gotten up a lot, and you know, I have to pay $15 extra to fill my tank all the way up from empty, so I'm kind of pissed that the prices are so high right now.
Gas prices have been real expensive lately because of a certain person, and I don't like it.
Okay, my opinion on gas prices going up. I think it's something that's affecting everyone. We don't always all agree on why. I think there's different ways or different people to blame on this. I'm not gonna say, but I think gas prices going up does affect me in a negative way because I do drive a lot. So whatever we can do to drop it down would be great.
Ridiculous, lots of money, unnecessary spent money.
I really wish they could go back down. I think that it has affected the surrounding areas, and I think that it's very important that we kind of stay within a range that's affordable for people that are around this area.
But it's very expensive. I drive a lot and don't get a lot of gas mileage.
But we've learned this.
They're still trying to figure out who is accountable at this point. ERCOT says I'm not to blame. The PUC says I'm not to blame. The legislature and the governor, I'm not to blame. So let's try and figure out a way to go forward and fix.
Make sure you put your seatbelt on.
Nah, I'm good.
Okay, told you so. Oh no!
Dude.
Told you so.
Strength smoothie. Call today, 865-409-1021, to order yours today. Side effects may include massive muscle gain, boosted confidence, peer recognition, change in physical appearance.
All right, announcements for the week. There are many scholarship opportunities available. Email your guidance counselor for more details. Girls at lacrosse is starting soon. Contact Ms. Bowers if you're interested. Season starts April 5th. Upcoming college visits will be held on Google Meets. University of Wisconsin will be held on Thursday, March 18th at 1:30. Normandale Community College will be on Tuesday, March 23rd at 10 a.m. And the University of Minnesota Duluth will be on Thursday, April 22nd at 9:30 a.m. Email Tammy Murray to receive the Google Meet links if interested.
Congratulations to the Students of the Month for March. Art, Justine Fries. Automotive, Alex Gregory. Business Education, Olivia Abdotrin.
Family and Consumer Science, Haley Karan. Industry, Technology, Education, John Radnick. And Language Arts, Faith Knutson.
Math, Danica Denhartog. Music, Mallory Jurek. Phi-Ed and Health, Carter Malika.
Science, Genevieve Lawrence. Social Studies, Ben Schmitz. And World Language, Annika Hunkin.
That's you.
Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Thanks for watching.
Such combos.
Okay, in three.